Well, we've got more reaction to that interview now, especially about the claims of racism, which came as Meghan talked about their son, Harry. Extraordinary, isn't it? Well, Royal Editor Russell Miles is still here. We're also joined by barrister Paula Rhone-Adrien, who says that she's seen racism in the establishment, sadly, firsthand. Thank you so much for joining us, Paula. I think Oprah's reaction summed everybody's reaction up. I mean, I was just like Oprah, I was like, what? It was astonishing, wasn't it?
No, it wasn't.
Really?
It was perfectly normal, and I wasn't surprised at all. And I would be shocked if the 3.2% of the black members of the British society were shocked. Jeez. I think Oprah was shocked.
Yes.
Because I think in Britain, we're very much led to believe that racism no longer exists. Mm. It's not a feature of our society. But unfortunately, Lorraine, it is. And there is nothing that Meghan said in the interview yesterday, or that Harry said in the interview yesterday, that came as a shock to me. In fact, it brought a tear to my eye, because what Meghan and Harry have done is they have voiced something that we all have wanted to voice about the pain that we go through, sometimes on a daily basis, when we have to leave our homes just to go to work so that we can earn some money, put some food on the table.
Paula,
nothing that she... shocking.
I'm so sorry, and I'm so glad that we are having this conversation, because reading your story as well, I mean, you're an incredibly successful, intelligent woman, obviously you are, but even when you go to your workplace, people don't think that you're a lawyer. They don't, just because of the colour of your skin.
Absolutely. So I have reported the racist abuse that I have suffered, but it took me 20 years, Lorraine, to build up the courage to say something. And when I did, I received a lot of support, but a bit of a backlash, because nobody wanted to accept that another barrister could say to another barrister,
right,
excuse me, but this room is only for barristers, can you leave, please? Or I'm talking to the barristers, can you leave? You know, that happens to me all the time. And it's not a member of the public saying to me, this is a highly educated, privately educated person looking at me as the only person of colour in the room, as I often am. There's only 597 of us out of some 17,000. Mm. So they turn to the only black person in the room and they tell me to leave.
It's shameful. It's absolutely shameful. So do you think that she's done, I guess, all of us a favour by bringing this up in the first place, by talking about it?
Absolutely. We have to challenge ourselves, Lorraine. For there to be positive change, we have to allow ourselves to look in the mirror and to challenge ourselves and discuss really difficult topics. And there is no doubt that discussing racism is a difficult topic. Nobody puts their hand up voluntarily and says, I'm a racist. Nobody even wants to put their hand up voluntarily and say, I am a part of a system that allows racism to exist and to fester and to poison and to impact on people's mental health. There is a reason, Lorraine, why only 3.2% of the black people in this society resonate so highly in the mental health system. It wears us down. Lorraine, every day when I go to work, I put my armor on. I put my armor on because I don't know if today I'm going to be asked to leave. I don't know if today I'm going to be called the N-word. So I put my armour on, but it's tiring. It's heavy to wear that armour every day.
Well, of course it is. And it's terrible. And do you know what, Paula? Because I'm in this wee bubble, and the way that I was brought up, and I'm in this bubble of, you know, telly land, and actually, I would say, in fact, everybody that I know is not racist. They're not. They really aren't. But I'm in a bubble, and see, talking to you, I mean, you've educated me more in 5 minutes, I think, than my whole life. And it's absolutely shocking. It really is. And it's really sad.
Well, let's talk about educating. Let's talk about that bubble really quickly. When I was younger, Lorraine, there was a very dynamic girl group. And they were amazing. And they were fantastic. And on Women's International Day, they were telling us about girl power. But the person who I was supposed to resonate with was called Scary. Scary Spice. And I don't know why she was scary. Was it because of the colour of her skin? Was it because of her hair? And 25 years on, we have a fantastic game show, a quiz show that's on, and the only person who is black on this quiz show, their name is the Dark Destroyer. Now, I don't allow my children to watch the first 10 minutes of this amazing, fantastic quiz show because I don't want to hear my children hear this amazing mastermind champion being described purely down to the colour of his skin. And not only is this amazing, sensitive person being described about the colour of his skin, he's called the Dark Destroyer. Not the big brain,
right?
But the Dark Destroyer. So, yes, you can tell me that you don't know anyone is racist, but we live in a world where ignorance breeds. And what Meghan and Harry have done is they have forced us all to look within. And the royal family as an institution have to look within. We can have a conversation about what colour a mixed race baby is going to be. Oh my God, is it going to be light? Is it going to be dark? Is it going to have blue eyes? Is it going to have brown eyes? We all talk about what a baby is going to look like. But we talk about what colour a child is going to be in the context of how dark that child is going to be, and I have to start to worry.
Paula, thank you for joining us this morning. I really, really appreciate it. And at least after what happened last year in the summer and after, you know, what Meghan has said, at least people will be having the conversations. And that's what I really hope, that people don't, because you know sometimes you don't want to because you just think, oh, am I going to cause offence, or is somebody going to be angry with me? We've got to start talking to one another, because, I mean, really, who cares what the colour of anybody's skin is? We're all human beings just trying to get on with our lives. And that's the main thing. But we have to have dialogue, don't we?
Well, this is where the royal aides have really let the royal family down. Can I just put this out there? Because my heart goes out to the royal family. It really, really does. You know, you're talking about Meghan Markle, whose grandparents, we are told, worked in a hotel for whites only. And then we have Harry, whose grandmother is a ruler of a kingdom. Who is surprised that there were going to be these cultural issues that everyone was going to have to overcome? Who's surprised at that? Yeah. Why wasn't there the level of support put in? Why isn't there a professional mediator going in and helping this family who's in crisis? Because we have a grandfather who is not seeing his grandchild. We have great grandparents who are not seeing their grandchild. This is a family in crisis, and they need to be helped. And the royal aides, they need to be positive about this and challenge some positive energy to make this right. And they can make it right, Lorraine. We don't have to think about this negatively.
No, we don't. Paula, maybe you should go in and talk to them. I think that would be a good idea. I think they should give you a call. Thank you so, so much for talking to us this morning. I really, really appreciate it. I really do. Don't forget, you can watch full episodes of Lorraine on the ITV Hub and all the best clips, compilations and playlists right here on our channel. Just subscribe now and you'll never miss an upload. Click here to watch another video similar to this one, or click here to head to our channel's homepage to explore all of our exciting videos.